Welcome to RSET online lecture series. Myself Guinness K. John, Assistant Professor, Department of Triple E, RSET. Good day to all. In this lecture, we will be discussing on 3-phase induction motor speed control, which is in the fourth module of electric drive course. In last lecture, we discussed DC drives. In DC drives, we had some problems that we discussed in the last classes. So here we will be discussing the speed control of induction motor drive. So before we are going to study the speed control of induction motor drive, we should know why we are going for the induction motor. So we know the main problem with DC drives are this maintenance because of brushes and commutator arrangement. The maintenance is required, continuous maintenance is required. To overcome that problem, we can go for induction. To overcome that problem, we can use induction motor where maintenance is very less. So we can use in all dirty and explosive environment. It is cheap, it is highly efficient. So this used for constant and variable speed applications. So let us have the revision of the induction motor drives. So there in this, we had to know construction of 3-phase induction motor that you have studied in the last semester. So there are two types of induction motor, the squirrel cage and wound rotor, or wound rotor or a slip ring induction motor. And we should know the equivalent circuit and performance curve and different methods of starting. All this we have studied last semester, so we had to revise those topics. So let us directly come to our topic of today's lecture, that speed control of 3-phase induction motor. For this topic, you can refer the textbook Gopal K. Dubey, The Fundamentals of Electrical Drives. So there are a few methods for control of induction motor. The first one is pole changing method. That can be used only for the squirrel cage type motor. Then we have a stator voltage controls, supply frequency control and eddy current control that can be used for both squirrel cage and wound type motors. And we have rotor resistance control and slip power recovery schemes which can be used only for wound rotor type motor. So let us start with torque equation of the induction motor with the equivalent circuit. So we have seen this equivalent circuit in the last semester, we have studied that. In this, we know the basic equation is the speed of the rotor is omega ms into 1 minus s, where omega m is the rotor speed or motor speed, omega m is the synchronous speed of the motor. Then equation number 1 gives current, rotor current equation. Equation number 2 gives power transfer to the air gap power. Then we have rotor copper loss. Then we have the equation for electric power converted into the mechanical power. That is the equation number 3. Then the torque, from there we can find the torque. The torque is equal to the power by speed. So substituting those values here, that is equation, comparing equation 2 and 4, we can write the torque equation of the motor as air gap power PG by the synchronous speed. Now let us see the first speed control techniques, that is stator voltage control. So in this method, the supply frequency is kept constant and voltage is varied. So this can be easily done by your AC voltage controller that we have studied in the last semester power electronics classes. So these are the basic configuration of AC voltage controller. So here we just vary the firing angle of the thyristors so that we can control the RMS values of the output voltage, so that we can control the speed of the induction motor. So the application of this type of control where torque demand reduces with speed. So here you can see in this the speed is in the y axis, x axis in the torque. So whenever the V1 is a higher value of voltage, V2 is a lesser value of voltage, the voltage reduces, the speed reduces. When our speed reduces, accordingly torque will be reduced. So let us see the motor efficiency with the stator voltage control, that is efficiency equation that we have seen, as by considering equation number 2 and 4, by considering neglecting stator losses and windage losses, we can write the efficiency equation as 1 minus s. That is, whenever speed reduces, slip increases. Whenever slip increases, efficiency will be reduced. What are the advantage? We have few advantage of the circuit. The control circuit is simple, is more compact and less weight. Its response time is quick. Considerable saving in energy, and hence it is economical. So, saving of energy is advantage over here. The disadvantage is the input power factor is very, very low, and the pure performance at the lower speeds. Maximum torque available from motor decreases with the stator voltage. Then at low speeds, motor current are excessive, and a special arrangement should be provided to limit the excessive current. Now, let us see the variable frequency control. So, in this control, we can adjust the frequency. Either we can use the inverter, or we can use cycle converter. So, there are two cases we can discuss over here. There is a low frequency operation at the constant voltage, and high frequency operation at the constant voltage. So, let us start with the first one, low frequency operation at the constant voltage. We know the basic equation as the voltage is equal to 4.44 k w phi m f into t 1. So, here voltage is constant, frequency is varied. When frequency is varied, the phi can be varied. So, here by if you are reducing the speed frequency of the supply, okay, keeping constant voltage, the air gap flux increases. Here we can see that we have the frequency is 1 by considering all the terms are constant. So, air gap flux will increase. So, magnetic circuit will get saturated. So, due to this lower frequency, reactance is low, because we know reactance is 2 pi f into L. When f is low, the reactance value is going to be low. So, leading to the high current, which results in more losses and less efficiency. Then second case is high frequency operation at the constant voltage. Here frequency is increased. So, if frequency increases at a constant voltage, the motor speed also increases. We can know frequency increases, motor speed increases. So, due to increase in frequency, flux and torque reduces, starting torque reduces, starting current decreases, and maximum torque reduces. Now, let us see the torque equation with the V and F ratios. So, we know this is our basic torque max is the basic equation that we have seen. Let us rewrite this torque equation like this. Here what we will do is the omega, we know omega m is 2 pi f, and x we know is a reactance that is 2 pi f into L. So, by considering then rearranging that above equation is 2 T max is going to be this. So, k into V by f whole square R s by f plus or minus into R s by f whole square plus 4 pi square into L s plus L r square into 1 by 2 raised to 1 by 2. At not so low frequency, this R s by f term, the R s by f term is going to we can neglect that term, because so not so low frequency that can be neglected. So, the T max become k into V by f whole square by 2 pi L s into L r dash. So, we can see that we have a relation at T max is equal to some V by F ratio. So, let us considering that equation, let us write our equations for a constant voltage and frequency control. There are basically two types of the speed control, that is speed control for above the base speed and below the base speed. So, in the if you are bringing the voltage the below the frequency below the voltage without changing voltage, we can show the air gap flux density increases, that causes saturation. So, what we have to do is we have to maintain the ratio is a constant value. Then the speed control above the base speed, if in that condition if we speed is speed base speed is increased, if voltage is go beyond the rated value, that can affect the insulation, may get affected. So, we cannot go for the voltage above the we cannot increase the voltage above this base speed value. Now let us see the voltage frequency relation. So the x axis we have frequency, the y axis we have voltage, and till this rated voltage value V rated, we can adjust both voltage and frequency. Then after reached is the rated value, we cannot increase the voltage, but only we can vary the frequency. So this is the base frequency, rated frequency value. So this is the relation between voltage and frequency of the speed control of induction motor. Okay. Now let us see that speed torque characteristics of the 3-phase induction motor speed. Here till this point, that is synchronous speed, this we can have a V by F ratio, we can adjust V by F ratio, and this torque is constant. You can see torque is constant. When after the rated base speed or base frequency, we cannot increase the voltage, only frequency can be varied. So the accordingly torque will be reduced and speed will be increased. These are the advantages of the above method. That is, first one, the speed control and braking operation is possible from zero speed to above base speed. So all type of range, the base from zero to above base speed, the speed control is possible. Then during the transients, operation can be carried out at the maximum torque with reduced current, giving good dynamic response. We can have better dynamic response. Thus, the speed drop in speed from no load to full speed is very small. Then the copper losses are low and efficiency and power factor are high, as operation is restricted between synchronous speed and maximum torque point at all the frequencies. These are the applications that pump, fans, blowaways, conveyors, machine tools, etc. applications of the speed control technique. Then the variable frequency drives with the squirrel cage induction motor can be used in applications involving explosive and contaminated environment like mines and chemical industries. So this is a block diagram for this variable frequency control. We have a induction motor and we have a supply. To control the voltage and frequency, we have a variable frequency variable supply block. To the variable frequency and a variable supply block, we have a reference or V star and F star. This voltage V star is from given from the flux control, so which will be decided what are the value of the voltage should be given to the motor will be decided by the flux control. Then we have a frequency block that we have frequency value, that frequency is passed through delay element and reaches to variable frequency variable supply box. We are keeping a delay element here to limit the fast variation of the speed. Whenever if F is increased a large value, if F is increased a large value, speed should not be increased very fastly. So we have to give a delay so that speed will be adjusted. This is the explanation of this block diagram. In next lecture, we will be discussing slip speed control. Thank you.